other provinces appear to be able to do. Now, from the medical perspective and the supply of medical cannabis and recreational cannabis, I'd like to hear you, perhaps Mr. Lucas, Mr. Saint Louis, Madam, comment on where these products should be obtained, the medical cannabis, if it can be found in two separate places, would that be a solution to address the issues surrounding branding and quality when it comes to the taxation system? Because Mr. Lucas is talking about having a zero tax rate on medicinal cannabis, but a tax on the recreational cannabis. So what type of solutions would you see there? Would the products be sold in two separate places, or what would your solutions be?
Je crois que c'est une partie de la...
Well, I think that would be part of the solution, in fact. I think that for medical distribution is something that's done using e-commerce. And there's no doubt that it'll end up in pharmacies and drugstores. And I think that that's perfectly appropriate. Not necessarily the buds or the cannabis flowers, but extracts like capsules and oils. So I think that that would be well placed in pharmacies where there are distributors who would be educated on the specific use of medicinal cannabis. So we agree with that, and I have no doubt that that's the way it's going. With respect to recreational cannabis, clearly that will separate the markets. However, we need to have more than just a location, if you will, to describe it.
Right now, if we did a comparison of the beer industry right now, let's say we had a beer industry that only allowed white labeling of beer, and so the label would only say the alcohol level, and that would be in. I wouldn't presume to know what the members of this committee like to drink, but if you're someone who favors a smaller batch brewer or a higher quality beer, there'd be absolutely zero incentive for that brewery to continue making high quality product because everything would become Old Milwaukee. And the reason it would become Old Milwaukee is because there'd be no reason for anyone to focus on quality if there'd be no way to differentiate the quality of one product from another. And so I think it's so important that we realize that if we want to support smaller growers, if we want to encourage quality products to be produced out there for Canadians, then we need to be able to allow some limited branding to adults in order to encourage those distributors, those producers, to focus on a quality product. If it's purely white-labeled, people are going to be growing fields of very low-quality cannabis, and that's all that's going to be available to Canadians in the